Hello, students. You are welcome to today's teaching. I am still your friend and your teacher, Muotoh from the Department of Mathematics, St. Charles College, Onitsha, Anambra State. Today, I'll be taking you on a topic called combination, still on the same subject, further mathematics. Sit back and relax, because by the end of the lesson, you should be able to state the formula for combination and solve problems on combinations correctly. Then the contents of this lesson are definition of combination, combination formula, combination problems without condition, and combination probability. Your previous lesson should be that you have learned permutation and can solve simple problems on the same topic. Then let's take a few questions on the permutation we have done previously. Supposing you are asked to find 5 factorial. You know, 5 factorial will give us 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Remember, in factorial, the numbers are decreasing by 1, beginning from the value you are given. So 5 factorial as expressed will give us 120 as an answer, which you can also use your calculator to find. Then number 2 example says find 4 permutation 2. Now how do you get 4 permutation 2? Remember the formula for your permutation, which is n permutation r, as seen on the screen, is given as n factorial over n minus r, or in bracket factorial. Remember, your n is the one at the up, then your r is at the base. So for you to solve 4 permutation 3, your n there is 4 and your r is 3. Then when you substitute them in the formula, you are going to have 4 factorial over 4 minus 3, all in bracket factorial, which when you simplify, you are going to have 24. Then let's take a few more questions on permutation. In how many ways can 2 letters be arranged from the word ABC? Remember, in permutation, order of arrangement is very important. Then for the arrangement, you see it. To arrange 2 letters from that word ABC, you have AB, BA, AC, CA, BC, and CB. So in this, you have 6 total ways of arrangement. You observe that your AB and BA are different identities as far as permutation is concerned. Okay, having understood that, you have seen that we have 6 ways of arranging that letter, 2 letter ways from the letters A, B, and C. Okay, let's go to the topic proper. And what is combination? Combination is the selection or choosing of R objects from N objects. And in combination, order of arrangement is not important, unlike you have it in permutation. And that is why in permutation, you were able to observe that AB and BA are 2 different identities. But in combination, AB and BA are the same, irrespective of their ordering, they are the same, provided the 2 important letters there are A and B. So, irrespective of how they were ordered, AB is the same thing as BA in combination. Okay, let's go to this example. In how many ways can 2 letters be selected from the word ABC? For you to select 2 letters from the lettered word ABC, we have AB is the same thing as BA. So we have 1 letter there, 1 arrangement there. Then AC is the same thing as CA, which is another 1 arrangement. Then BC is the same thing as CB. So the total ways of arranging 2 letters from the word ABC are 3, which are AB, AC, and BC only as an answer. Okay, we go to combination formula. Combination is represented by number of permutation over arrangement of R objects. To cut the whole matter short, combination is denoted by N combination R is equal to N factorial over n minus r all in bracket factorial r factorial seen at the denominator. You observe that there is a slight difference between permutation and combination. So when you are getting your combination formula, if you are able to remember that in permutation, it is given as n factorial over n minus r all in bracket factorial. For you to now get your combination formula, simply add r factorial at the denominator of that your permutation formula, and that gives us the combination formula. I take that again. Combination is given by n combination r is equal to n factorial over n minus r all in bracket factorial r factorial, where you have known that your n represents the number of objects, your r represents the object considered at that time. Then also remember that n is greater or equal to r. Remark that n combination 0 is equal to 1. Example, when you have 3 combinations 0, we give you 1. So when a number is combined with 0, it is just a 1. N combination 1 will give you n. Take for instance, 3 combination 1 will give us 3. The same thing as 7 combination 1, it is a 7. N combination n, that is 3 combination 3, which is same thing as 7 combination 7, will give us a 1. Then n combination r is equal to n combination n minus r. What it means is that if you are asked to find 5 combination 3, it is the same thing as 5 combination 2. If you watch the base, you find that when you add the 2 and 3, as you are seeing on the screen, it gives you that 5. So in that case, 5 combination 2 is the same thing as 5 combination 3. Also noted that words like choose and select are used for combination. The word formed can also be used in combination just as it is used in permutation. But the only thing is that the student has to be careful to know if the question needs arrangement, if the order of arrangement is important in that question. If the order of arrangement is important, what it simply means that the question is permutation. But if the order is not important, then the question becomes a combination. I hope you are still there with me. Then let's go to combination problems. Remember, we are looking at combination without a condition, or combination that has no restriction. That is a normal combination. And combination, when I call it combination, is tempting as saying selection or choosing. Okay, first example says, evaluate 4 combination 3. What does 4 combination 3 mean? 4 combination 3 means to select 3 from 4. So for you to select 3 from 4, it means that our n is 4 and our r is 3. Then looking at the formula at the top screen, the formula for combination is giving us n factorial over n minus r all in bracket factorial r factorial. So when you substitute the values of n and r in the given formula, then we are going to have 4 combination 3 is equal to 4 factorial over 4 minus 3 all in bracket factorial 3 factorial. When you simplify, you have 4 factorial over 4 minus 3 will give us 1 factorial 3 factorial. Then when you simplify further, you have 4 times 3 factorial over 1 times 3 factorial. Then 3 factorial at the numerator cancels 3 factorial at the denominator, so that our answer will give us 4. Okay, we go to the next example. 5 combination 3 times 6 combination 4. So what you do here, first of all, you get 5 combination 3. And 5 combination 3 will give us 5 factorial over 5 minus 3 all in bracket factorial 3 factorial. When you simplify, you get here 10. 10 is not yet the answer. So what you do again is you get 6 combination 4. And 6 combination 4 will give us 6 factorial over 6 minus 4 all in bracket factorial 4 factorial, which when you simplify will give us 15. Then 5 combination 3 times 6 combination 4 will now give us, remember, 5 combination 3 gave us 10 and the 6 combination, 4, gave us 15. So the sign joining these two combinations is multiplication. So you multiply 10 and 15 together to give us 150 as an answer. Then the next question there says 6 combination 2 plus 6 combination 3. Remember the formula is still at the top screen. 6 combination 2 will give us 6 factorial over 6 minus 2, all in bracket factorial 2 factorial, which when you simplify gives you 15. Then solve for 6 combination 3. 6 combination 3 will give us 6 factorial over 6 minus 3, all in bracket factorial 3 factorial, which when you simplify will give us 20. Then bring the two respective answers. Then it gives us 6 combination 2 plus 6 combination 3 is equal to 15 plus 20. And when you add them together, it gives us 35 as an answer. Okay. So in the second question, we have if n combination 2 is equal to 15, find the n. In that question, our n is n and our r is 2. The formula for combination is seen at the top screen. Then, using that formula, n combination 2 will give us n factorial over n minus 2, all in bracket factorial 2 factorial. Remember that n factorial is equal to n into n minus 1 in brackets into n minus 2 in bracket factorial. I chose to stop at n minus 2 all in bracket factorial because the denominator of the question has n minus 2 all in bracket factorial. In case it does not have n minus 2 all in bracket factorial, I will continue to extend my numerator till the desired point. But since it shares the same value, there is no need extending it. For easier cancellation, I have to stop at n minus 2 all in bracket factorial. Then substituting, we have n combination 2 will now be replaced with n factorial over n minus 2 all in bracket factorial 2 factorial, which is equal to 15. Then our n minus n factorial has been replaced with n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 factorial over n minus 2 in bracket factorial 2 times 1. Then n minus 2 all in brackets factorial, we cancel the n minus 2 all in bracket factorial at the numerator. In that case, we're going to have n into n minus 1 all in brackets over 2 is equal to 15 over 1. Then when you expand, we are going to have, by cross multiplying, we are going to have n, we multiply n to give us n squared, and n we multiply minus 1 to give us minus n. Then 2, we multiply 15 to give us 30. Then when we simplify, we have n squared minus n minus 30 is equal to 0. That gives us a quadratic equation. Then when you factorize it, it's not a must you can factorize. If you like, you can use a quadratic formula. If you also like, you can use completing the square method. But for easier solving, we chose factorization method. But remember that it has given us quadratic equation. Then when you factorize, we have n squared, the two numbers, and when you multiply, it gives you minus 30, minus 6 and plus 5. Then you replace it so that when you add minus 6 and plus 5, it gives you minus 1 as the coefficient of n in that equation. Then when you expand again, you have n into n minus 6 plus 5 into n minus 6 equal to 0. Then collect them together, you have n plus 5 in brackets and n minus 6 in brackets equal to 0. In that case, our n will give us minus 5 and 6. But remember, our n must not be negative. In that case, our n is a positive 6 as an answer. Then let's go to another question. If 18 combination R is equal to 18 combination R plus 2, find R combination 6. That is a weird question. Then let's go from the left-hand side. From the left-hand side, we have 18 combination R is equal to 18 factorial over 18 minus r all in brackets r factorial. In this question, our n is 18 and our r still remains r. Remember, the formula for combination is seen at the top screen. Okay, from the right hand side also, 18 combination r plus 2 is equal to 18 factorial. Our n in this question is 18 and our r is r plus 2. So we have 18 factorial over 18 minus our r is r plus 2 all in bracket factorial. Then your r, you replace it also with r plus 2 all in bracket factorial. When you simplify, you have 18 factorial over, expand these brackets, it will give us 18 minus r minus 2, which when you add them up, it gives you 16 minus r all in bracket factorial, r plus 2 all in bracket factorial. Then when you bring the left and the right hand sides together, we are going to have 18 factorial over 18 minus r all in bracket factorial, r factorial is equal to 18 factorial over 16 minus r all in bracket factorial r plus 2 all in bracket factorial. By expanding it and cross multiplying, we are going to have r plus 2 all in bracket into r plus 1 all in bracket is equal to 18 minus r into 17 minus r all in bracket. Then expanding, we have r squared plus r plus 2r plus 2 is equal to 306 minus 18r minus 17r plus 12. Then when you collect them together, 38r is equal to 304. Divide by the coefficient of r, then our r gives us 8. Then to find r combination 6 as the question required, it will give us 8 combination 6 because our r has been gotten as 8. So we have 8 combination 6 will give us 8 factorial over 8 minus 6 all in bracket factorial 6 factorial. Then when you solve it, it gives you 28 as an answer. I hope you are still there with me. Remember, it's very important that you note that you can also solve combination using your calculator. Using the calculator on the screen, what you simply do, if you want to get 12 combination 5, you press the button 1, which is your 12, then press button 2, which is shift button, press button 3, which is that division button. On top of it, there is combination at the top. So with the button 3 you have pressed, then press your equality sign. And when you do that, it gives you 792 as an answer. So 12 combination 5 will give us 792 as an answer. Okay, we go to what problems on combination. The first question says, a committee of 8 is to be chosen from 10 persons. In how many ways can this be done if there is no restriction? If you look at the picture, you will see there are 10 men there. So we are selecting 8 from them. It's a combination question because in this selection, order is not important. Our concern is just to find 8 people, irrespective of their ordering. So in that case, it's a combination problem. And we are going to have our n is 10 and our r is 8. So we have 10 combination 8, which when you simplify gives you 45 ways. Then number 2, a committee of 2 boys and 3 girls are to be formed from 4 boys and 7 girls. In how many ways can this committee be formed? This is a combination problem, irrespective of the fact that we use the word formed. In this selection, order is not important. So if you look at the picture, it gives you a picture of what we are doing. Then we are selecting 2 boys from a total of 4 boys. And we are also selecting 3 girls from a total of 7 girls. So to select 2 boys from 4 boys, it gives us 4 combination 2, which when you simplify will give us 6. Then to select 3 girls from 7 girls, it will give us 7 combination 3, which when you simplify will give us 35. Then our and is times. So when you bring them together, we have 4 combination 2 times 7 combination 3 will give us 6 times 35, which will give us 210 as an answer. Then the number 3 question says, Find the number of ways of selecting 15 balls consisting of 5 black balls, 5 blue, and 5 white balls from a box which contains 6 black, 7 blue, and 8 white balls. That is the picture shown there. Then for us to select 5 black balls, 5 blue balls, and 5 white balls from 6 black balls, 7 blue ball, and 8 white balls respectively, we have 6 combination 5 times 7 combination 5 times 8 combination 5. Then when you simplify them separately, we have 6 combination 5 will give us 6, 7 combination 5 will give us 21, and 8 combination 5 will give us 56. When you multiply them together, we are going to have 7,056 ways as an answer. Then number 4 says, 5 female and 7 male teachers applied for 4 vacancies in a junior high school. The teachers are equally qualified. Find the number of ways of employing the 4 teachers. That is the picture shown there. Now, how do you solve this? For us to select 4 teachers from 5 female and 7 male teachers, what we simply do is to add the total number of teachers, which are 5 plus 7, give us 12. Then we make our selection. We are selecting 4 teachers. It doesn't matter the gender. It can be male, it can be female, or all through male and female. So we are selecting 4 from the total number of teachers that came for the interview, and that will give us 12 combination 4, which when you simplify will give us 495 ways. Then we go to combination probability. This is applying probability in combination. So for probability of occurrence, you have number of required outcome over number of all possible outcomes. Example, what is the probability of selecting a committee of 3 men and 2 women from a group of 10 men and 6 women? Remember, we're selecting 3 men from 10 men, and we're also selecting 2 women from 6 women. Then the required outcome will now be, for men selection, it is 10 combination 3. For women selection, it is 6 combination 2. Then when you multiply 10 combination 3 times 6 combination 2, it will give us 120 times 15, which will give us 1,800. Then number of all possible outcomes means we are selecting total of 3 men and 2 women will give us 5. And total of 10 men and 6 women will give us 16. So when we are selecting 5 from 16 people, that is the normal selection. It will give us 16 combination 5, which will give us 4,368. Then the probability will now be the required outcome, which is 1,800 over the possible outcome, which is 4,368. When you simplify, it gives you 75 over 182 as an answer. Okay, we have finally come to the end of this lesson. I hope you really learned a lot. The questions for you to answer are, 1, simplify 12 combination 5 minus 5 combination 2. 2, if n plus 1 combination 3 is equal to 7 into n combination 2, find the n and other questions attached to this. Solve them and submit them to my WhatsApp number 080-69-46-71-27. Thank you for your audience. Bye-bye.